functioning perfectly. So, ready to begin. This is the fourth session of this type that I've done here at Mindfully Well Center in Yellow Springs, Ohio. So we've done different themed meditations followed by sound healing. So we did gratitude last November, we did giving for the holidays in December, we did the new beginnings of New Year's resolutions in January, we did self-love and healing last month in April, and now we're doing spring renewal. It's definitely in the thick of springtime, almost summer in a month. So springtime, you know, you see all these beautiful flowers blooming. It's rebirth, it's new growth, it's just life, just the beauty of living, growing things. And we've done all kinds of different meditations during these sessions, various themes and mantras and things. And now what I'd like to do is kind of returning to something that I did way back in November, I believe it was, in the first session or the second session, which is the chakra balancing meditation. And I think it's really appropriate for this idea of new beginnings. It's great for intention setting, and it's spring cleaning. So it's like clearing out from the chakras. So you can think of this as cleaning, refreshing, clearing every aspect of our being through each of these aspects of our life or our body, mind, spirit, the chakras. So we're going to tune in with our opening mantra as we do before every Kundalini practice, and we'll be going through each chakra, doing vibration and some affirmations. Before we get down into the sound healing concert, this can be done from laying down, but you'll be more energized and more engaged with a tall spine, so you can sit up on a little bolster, little blanket, cushion, whatever you have. Get that tall spine. We'll roll the shoulders up and back a few times. Just get loosened up. You can roll your neck around a bit if you like. Just keeping those shoulders, face, jaw relaxed. And then we'll draw the palms together and just rub just to kind of awaken a little circulation in the body, a little wakefulness in the mind. But before we get into our deep relaxation sound journey, we'll set some intentions through the chakras. So now we bring the palms together at the heart center, thumbs pressed gently to the breastbone so you can feel into your heart. And you're relaxing from head to toe, so the eyes are just gently gazing between the eyebrows, the third eye point. Relax through the base of your spine, face and jaw. Just nice and easy, and just feeling your body in your seat, in this space, in this moment. Feel your breath filling up the belly and the heart. We just recorded a beautiful video that Diana led, breathing, talking about breathing into the diaphragm, the belly, and the heart, that you can check out pretty soon when we get that released for you. But just some couple more deep breaths just to revitalize, fill yourself up with that prana, the life force energy on the breath. Let's do a few sighing breaths. Let's inhale through the nose and sigh out the mouth. Sigh all the breath out. A little stress relief. One more time. We tune in. Every Kundalini practice, every class in the world, every home practice begins with three rounds. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. It's a simple mantra. It's like four words, the vibration of the universe, ONG. Om Namo, meaning to honor that. Guru Dev, meaning the great celestial wisdom, that which guides us, that guiding light, your intuition, golden chain of teachers, every bit of wisdom and guidance and light and love in the universe is carried on this vibration. It's Om Namo Guru Dev Namo, with the palms at the heart. We'll inhale to begin. Hands together at the heart. Om Namo. Interlocking your pinky fingers. For the first chakra, for root chakra, there's a mudra, hand position for each chakra. I'll be giving you some English affirmations, some of the qualities of each of these centers. So feel your sitting bones, feel those points where you're connected to the support underneath you. Kind of just relaxing, grounding. This is the root muladhara, root support. The red light, lotus of four petals. The most basic survival instincts, the earth element, before you can get up into the higher ideals of love and the consciousness. First, you just have to feel safe. And there's the analogy in Western psychology is Maslow's hierarchy of needs. They find people can't experience consideration for each other or higher critical thinking abilities. That's why they say you don't do well on a test if you're panicking. If you're panicking, you can't remember things because you're in fight or flight. But if you just allow yourself to kind of settle and be comfortable in this moment in your body, that's your foundation before you get up to the higher centers. It's like imagining roots down from the base of your spine. Just feel very stable, like you're rooted down to the center of the earth. I'll give you a few affirmations to set your intentions here. And a little bit different actually than an intention, because an intention is setting something for a potential future. Affirmation is affirming it right here in this moment. You'd be saying, I am this in this moment. So the pinkies interlocked, the hands just relaxed in your lap. You can repeat after me. I am grounded and centered.
I am grounded and centered.
I am safe and secure.
I am safe and secure.
I trust more, I fear less.
I trust more, I fear less.
I honor my body as a temple.
I honor my body.
And I have nothing to fear.
I have nothing to fear.
We'll be vibrating the Sanskrit seed syllable, which is lam. So we'll do a deep breath and we'll harmonize together lam, 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 as long as that breath lasts. We'll do another deep breath and we'll do one long lam. You hold that M, feel all the vibrations in your lips, vibrates all these nerves and calms the nervous system, very healing. Inhale deep.
Lum, 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 lum.
Thank you. interlock the ring fingers and feel the space above the base of your spine. It's an orange light, reproductive organs, hormones, emotions, desires, creativity. It's a water element. Just like water, we want our emotions to be able to flow. Sometimes we suppress and repress, and I know a lot of you involved with this field of psychology, you know the danger with that. If you resist, you know, what we consider negative emotions, like anger, desires, like what we consider inappropriate desires or something. There's a lot of repression, and you see what happens when people are repressed. It's like holding a little puppy as it like struggles and tries to get away, and just creates a lot of frustration, a lot of psychosis. So we want to honor our emotions, honor desire as a natural thing. We don't try to, you know, for example, fasting, like we know if we overindulge in some junk food, we'll be a very unhealthy. We know if we never eat again, we'll die. So it's moderation. That's what brahmacharya is. You know, say you enjoy chocolate. You know, it's a very healthy superfood if you get raw chocolate. You enjoy a bar of chocolate. Now say, well, it's something good. I like it. I want to indulge. Say you ate like a big bucket of chocolate. And think about how you might feel. You would get very sick. So this is going to help us balance the aspect of desires, of emotions. So you can repeat after me. I honor all my emotions. My desire is pure.
My desire is pure.
I release any unhealthy habits.
I release any unhealthy habits.
I allow myself to feel.
And I allow myself to feel.
Repressing nothing.
Repressing nothing.
Expressing in healthy ways.
Expressing in healthy ways.
Balancing this chakra will vibrate the sound of vam. Inhale deep. Sometimes people refer to this in other traditions as the solar plexus, but behind your solar plexus is your heart, and your navel itself, you have your abdominal muscles. That's a big part of your strength and your sense of self, like your sense of confidence, you know, to hold yourself up with good posture, to speak from your navel. This is what it sounds like when I'm speaking from my navel. There's a power there. So this is your personal fire. The ego is also involved here, which also something that people kind of repress if they're trying to, you know, renounce. You know, obviously we don't want to be narcissistic or have too much ego, but you don't want to have too little ego and not be dignified, not be able to stand up for yourself. For example, if someone was abusing you or something, to think that you deserve that or something, you know. The idea here is we're all equal. So to balance that ego, I'll give you some affirmations for that. So this is, if you envision like the sun, like a bright, hot, fire, glowing, golden color right at your navel. Your navel is where all your nutrients come in through the umbilical cord. It's the seat of your power. It's one of the first things that forms in the fetus. So it's where all the energy comes in. It's the origin of all 72,000 nadis, the energy channels. So kind of draw your hands, like pull, like you're pulling your fingers apart so you can feel that lock, that power pull into the navel a little bit. Feel your core muscles. You're gonna feel your personal power here and build that so you feel like you deserve all of the greatness. You deserve to be treated well. And I'll give you some affirmations for that. You can repeat after me. I stand in my power.
I stand in my power.
I am courageous and whole.
I am courageous and whole.
Equal to all.
Equal to all.
My intentions are pure.
My intentions are pure.
My will aligned with the divine.
My will aligned with the divine.
There's no one above me, no one below me.
There's no one above me.
Nothing above me, nothing below me.
Nothing above me, nothing below me.
I have nothing to hide and nothing to prove.
I have nothing to hide and nothing to prove.
I am.
I am.
Powerfully vibrating the sound of Ram. Inhale deep. Ram, Ram, Ram. That fire. As you relax, release, and completely relax. And just breathe, be still. Feel that circulation flowing. Now we'll join the palms at the heart center. The heart anahata. I think we all know what the heart is about. It's love. It's a lot of emotion we experience in our heart. And there's kind of a misconception that emotion is all in your brain. But you know what happens when you get really excited or scared? Your heart starts beating really fast. Even when you're going through like a breakup, when your heart is hurt, we feel physical pain in the heart. And the heart stores a lot of memory and emotion. They've actually, when they do heart transplants, they'll see that person will start having dreams and start having cravings and for music and foods and things that that person that they didn't even know about had. So we're gonna send healing to our hearts. This is compassion, forgiveness for ourselves and for all beings. Very important work to do to open the heart, to be able to express love to those around you, especially right now. I'm not going to say these uncertain times, but at times when you know people are passing away, and you never know when you get to see someone again. So I say, you know, tell people you love them, and don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to get hurt. You know, just open your heart. It takes practice. It takes time. So we're going to do that now. It's a green light, anahata. It's the balance point. It's a six-pointed star between the lower three chakras. The lower triangle is the earthly, you know, went through earth, water, fire. And this is in the upper triangle. The upper three chakras are from the heavens, also masculine and feminine, joining together those two triangles to make the six-pointed star. So this is the balance point where the heavens and the earth come together in your heart. And we're considering the body, but also the spirit through love, through compassion. So you can repeat out, and this is an air element, by the way, too. Your lungs are here. So you can repeat after me. I allow myself to love.
I allow myself to love.
I let love in.
I
express love to all.
I express love to all.
I am love.
I am love.
All is love.
All is love.
I live in peace and gratitude.
Forgiving everyone.
Forgive myself.
I'm
going to do a few rounds of the hope and open. It's four statements. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. And thank you. So we're giving love, humility, humbling the ego, and gratitude. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. Inhale. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. Continue. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. Feel it from your heart. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. Once more from your heart. Inhale. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. Feel that expression, feel your heart opening. No fear, just love. Vibrating the sound, yum. Feeling that from your heart. Inhale.
Yum.
Is if we carry grudges, it's just hurting ourselves. So you can practice this frequently and free yourself from that. Now moving to throat chakra, we are blossoming open this open lotus mudra. It's thumbs, pinkies, and wrists connected. The other fingers blooming open. And feel your thumbs into the base of your throat, that little notch, to the voice box. Communication, expression. So we communicate really from all the different chakras in different ways, but this is where it comes through. So say you have some love in your heart or some artistic, you know, some concept, something you want to express, but if we have a closed throat chakra a lot of times from fear. If anyone's ever told you to shut up, to, you know, like your voice doesn't matter or you don't have a good voice or something, we get blocks. If we're dishonest, we get guilt and blocks in the throat chakra. It's a sky blue lotus of light. Vishuddha is an element of ether. So we're going even more refined than air. Ether is kind of like what holds space. And so we want to clear through those blocks. As the Buddha said, only what we speak, we only speak that which is beneficial to all beings, that which is necessary, and that which is truthful. So whenever we're going to say something, we let it pass through these three doors. Is it necessary? Is it beneficial? And is it truthful? Because sometimes we just speak unconsciously. We say things we don't mean. We say we're going to do things we don't really mean. And that can cause a lot of conflict. People remember these things, even if you're speaking unconsciously, giving someone, you know, lip service, as they say, like just kind of humoring someone, and they're like, hey, you didn't do what you said you're going to do, you start to look unreliable. So you want to honor our word. I'll let you set that intention, this affirmation. I speak my truth.
I speak my truth.
I honor my word.
I honor my word.
I use my words to create.
I use my words to create.
And not destroy. For the throat chakra. My throat chakra is closed now. There's nothing else to say. So we'll vibrate the sound hum. Inhale. Hum, hum. Tool, like a big heavy wrench. You can use this big heavy wrench to, you know, build and fix and create, or you can use it to harm. Or, you know, if you're carrying that big heavy wrench around all day, every day, if you're sleeping with it, it can be cumbersome and tiring. So meditation is putting the wrench down. It's setting that powerful tool down so it's not, and you know, not letting your mind dwell on things that are harming you or unnecessary or wasting your energy. Have a clear mind. That's what opening the third eye is really about. You know, you get psychic powers and visions, all these esoteric things, but really, we just all want to have a clear mind. So I'll give you some affirmations for this. My mind is clear.
My mind is clear.
I use my mind for my intentions. It doesn't use me.
It doesn't use me.
I honor my intuition.
I honor my intuition.
I honor my vision.
I honor my vision.
I can hold my vision.
I can hold my vision.
To create my intentions.
To create my intentions.
Vibrate the sound shyam. Inhale. Shyam, 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 shyam. Inhale, stretch up. Exhale and relax. Let the palms face up on your knees. First finger and thumb join Gyan Mudra. Feel the pulse there. We've come to the seventh final chakra that will work on the crown chakra. So the element of the third eye is light, and the element of the crown is beyond light. You can envision what's beyond light. What's faster than light? Spirit. It's the only thing beyond the mind. So it's a thousand-petaled lotus, sahasra. So you can envision that. Ever blooming, 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 a thousand petals, sahasra, lotus above the crown of your head, rolling the eyes all the way up, envisioning pure white light scintillating with every color of the rainbow in that white, bright radiance. It's beaming down energy from the center of the universe, filling up, blooming open, overflowing down through the third eye, the throat, heart, your navel, second chakra, your root. Just feel every cell in your body, every fiber of your being glowing, healing, filled with spirit, filled with love and light. Connect with spirit, with the universe, the divinity in all things. You can repeat after me. I honor my soul.
I honor my soul.
I honor my source.
I honor my source.
I am divine.
I am divine.
All is divine.
All is divine.
All is spirit. I embrace the unity of all beings.
I embrace the unity of all beings.
I am the universe.
I am the universe.
To complete our chakra balancing, we meditate on the sound of Om. One single vibration. Keep the eyes rolled all the way up, beaming down, opening up. This is your 10th gate, your opening to the universe. One Om. Inhale. Just breathe, just be, just feel. That you've addressed every chakra, every aspect of body, mind, spirit, of life, and the human condition, you can take this down to your savasana to integrate, relax, and heal. You can lie flat on your back if you want to do legs up the wall, but this is going to be like an hour, so probably want to just lie flat. You can also use a bolster, especially if you have sensitive knees. A little support under the knees would be appropriate. Maybe something under your head if you like. Traditionally you lie flat, but you can lie over a bolster and support yourself and cover up with a blanket if you like. Oh. you're not holding any unnecessary tension. Especially the face. Just let the eyes roll back so your forehead and jaw relax. This is your time. You've been gifted this time by the universe. You've created this time. Just get your deepest healing and relaxation. So let the whole body go, every finger, every toe. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
be of benefit, contribute to that well-being, that happiness for all. Loka Savasta Sukhino Bhavantu. May all beings everywhere be happy and free, including us as part of the whole, deserving as anyone. Let the wind be behind you, angels dance with you, and your consciousness guide you to victory. Let the angels, the great souls, the avatars, and all incarnations of God pray for you. Walk tall and bless all, in your innocence with your love, for each one's peace and prosperity. Remember what the time wants. Serve the needs of the time and space. You will be sacred, exalted, beautiful, bountiful, and fulfilled. From Yogi Bhajan. Puja Namana Pushpa Adya Yamati Kriyate Dridha Nirvikalpe Maha Vyomini Sa Puja Hi Adarat Laya. Radiant Sutra 147. Worship does not mean offering flowers. It means offering your heart to the vast mystery of the universe. It means letting your heart pulse with the life of the universe, without thought, without reservation. It means being so in love that you're willing to dissolve and be recreated in every moment. Thank you. iti etat kathitam nevi parama amritam uttamam etat cha na eva kasya api prakashyam tu kala chana. This is Radiant Sutra 157. Adorable goddess, these practices are a nectar I share with you. Drink from this cup whenever you are thirsty or crave to be refreshed in the essence of life. Know that this ambrosia is available to you everywhere, for the universe is made out of it. Simply go to the intersection of flesh and spirit. Breathe the tiny sparks that fly. Within this very body are many gateways to the infinite, where incarnation and immortality consummate their passion for each other. Something's happening on the Zoom. Spirits never die, but computers do die, and phones die. That's it's very sad. Oh, the hour's getting a little late for those of us waking up early and driving distances, so we'll just do our little closing blessing and we'll be on our way, so we'll do a little long time sun song, our final blessing.
Did you unplug here? Look. You'll just be there. You'll just be here then?
Okay. No, I don't know if that one's muted. It's giving me a message. I'm going to click that unmute myself button. From the Celtic blessing, which is how we close every Kundalini yoga class in the world. So we'll bring the palms together, get that energy waking up again, and then to the heart center we say this blessing. If you know it, if you want to sing along, you can, or you can catch on. We're going to do it three times, or you can just send the blessings from your heart. First time to yourself, second time to someone you know who needs it, last time to all beings. So all those who are suffering, all those who are ill, all those who we want to give gratitude for, who are fighting illness, all those beings in the universe, those who you're forgiving, everyone. May the long time sun shine upon you, all love surround you, the pure light within you guide your way.
Shine upon you, all love surround.
request before we sign off. Old friend of mine from high school, I just found out, committed suicide. And so I'd like to do this practice. We chant the sound akal, which means deathless. So it's to honor those souls, to guide those souls who have left their bodies, any soul, on their journey, and for mourning and comforting the people who, their loved ones. So it's akal, long, three long akals. Inhale. Peace to all, light to all, and love to all. SadaNam.